Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How are you guys? My name is Mahmoud. I'm an Arabic language tutor. I teach Quran and Arabic to non-native speakers. Welcome to this series of learning Arabic speaking from Quran. We're going to take parts of some verses in the Quran. We use them a lot in our Arabic talking, in our Arabic speaking. We're going to see the meaning of this verse and when we use this verse in our talking. Okay, and let's start today with this part of the verse of the last ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. What does this part of ayah means? لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. It means that Allah doesn't burden a soul beyond that it can bear. Allah doesn't burden a soul beyond that it can bear. Or simply, Allah doesn't order you or command you something you cannot do. Okay, Allah doesn't order you or ask you to do something you cannot do. Okay, or ask you to do something more than your limit. Okay. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Okay, when do we use this part of ayah in our talking, in our speaking, Arabic speaking? Okay, we use this part of ayah لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Okay, when someone is doing his best in something, when he wants to reach to a target, and he did his best, but he cannot reach. Okay. Because it's out of his limits. Okay, it's so hard for him. Okay, so we are encouraging him. Okay, we are encouraging him that to tell him, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. يعني take it easy with yourself if you cannot do it. Okay, we say this ayah to a father. Okay, who wants his son to be the best. Okay, or he wants his son to study something. Or study subject he cannot do, he cannot study because it's hard for him or he doesn't like it. Okay, so we tell him لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعا as advising. Okay, and you don't ask your kid to do something he cannot do. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعا. Or we say it to the manager, okay, who asks his workers or his employees, okay, to work some hours or extra hours than they usually do. For example, if they are working 8 hours, okay, and he wants them to do more 4 hours. Okay, this is so hard for them. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Okay, but we do not use this verse لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها in negative way. For example, if something you can do and you say no, I cannot do. Okay, like for example, we ask you to wake up early. You slept 8 hours, okay, and then after 8 hours we are waking you up, and you say, "Oh, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها." No, it's something you can do. You can wake up. You can wake up after 8 hours sleeping, even after 6 hours sleeping, you can wake up. Okay, لا يكلف الله. No, you cannot say this here. Okay. This ayah, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. For example, people, they can do more than they can do in usually. Any, okay, they can work out, for example, and work out hard. For the people who go to gym, for example, he can lift more. Okay, but in the future, okay, not now. In the future, but not now. Okay, we do not use this ayah with them. You do not say لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعا. No, with practice he will do inshallah more. But some things, okay, you have limits as human. Okay, we are not completed. We are not complete. For that, we use this ayah لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعا. We use it to encourage people, okay, or to tell them you did your best. No one will blame you. Okay, you did your best and you worked hard. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعا. And that's the end of our lesson today. I hope it's useful for you, inshallah. If you have any question, please write in the comment and I will reply to you. Don't forget to make dua for me and for my family. Thank you, and I see you in other lessons, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.